Hello everyone, welcome back to the Synthax UK YouTube channel. My name is Matt and today I've got a quick video for you on how you can use your Icon Platform M Plus as an expression and modulation controller for your virtual instruments. Now in our recent overview video, we talked about how the Platform M Plus can give you hands-on tactile control of your DAW sessions. We also mentioned how the Platform M Plus, with the help of some third-party apps, can work with other creative applications like Adobe's Lightroom Classic. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can use the Platform M Plus and the Platform X Plus expander units to control your virtual instruments inside your DAW. One of the key things to making virtual instruments sound realistic, especially those in an orchestral setting, is the use of expression and dynamic controls. Now, these two control command settings are usually pre-mapped to virtual instruments. So that means it's really easy for us to take the Platform M Plus in user-defined mode, use the Icon iMap software, and then we can program these control commands onto the Platform M Plus for use as an expression controller. And that's what I'm going to show you now in this video. So the first thing that I'm going to do is turn on my Platform M Plus, and then we need to move it to user-defined mode. Now that's done by having the fourth LED here illuminated. Now, if you're using it as a DAW controller, you'll probably be in mode 1 or mode 2. So use these selector buttons to go over to channel strip 4. And this LED is lit up, that means it's in user defined mode. Now, if you've been using this as a DAW controller, you'll need to go into your control surface preferences in your DAW and deselect or remove the Platform M Plus as a controller, because what's going to happen is that when we put it into user defined mode to use it as an expression controller, some of the messages that are being sent is going to get confused. I'll explain that a little bit more later when we open the iMap software. But for now, I'm in Logic, so I've gone into my control surface setup, click the Mackie control here, and just delete it. So that's gone now, and that means we are all done here in the control surface setup section. So now that I'm done in Logic, I can open the iMap software. Now the iMap software is a free download from the Icon website, and we'll put the link to that in the description box below. If I just open this, it's currently in Logic Pro mode. Now you can see here all of the buttons, select, mute, solo, record arm, even these transport controls up here, they all have certain command values. Now if I change the control mode here to user defined, which is what we're in, you can see all of these controls have now changed. And this is what I mean about the controls getting a bit confused when it comes to changing it to an expression controller, because the DAW controls are set up in a certain way and then you're going to be interrupting those. It's going to make things a little bit confusing. So by removing it from your DAW, you're eliminating that problem. So now what we're going to do here is we're just going to change these fader controls here. I'm going to use faders 1 and 2. There are two key control commands that are used in most virtual instruments, and that's CC1 and CC11. Now CC1 is the main modulation control. That is the modulation wheel on your MIDI keyboard, and that's what the majority of virtual instruments use as their dynamic control. So on the fader 1 here, I'm just going to change message type to CC, the channel can stay as 1, and then the message can be modulation. Now the other one is CC11, which is the expression control. Now this is used for a variety of different things in certain virtual instruments. So I'm going to change this again to CC channel 1 and then expression here, which is in this list. You can see these are a load of other general CC messages that you can use. Now one thing to note is that the Platform M Plus has touch sensitive faders. Now it's a touch sensitive portion of the fader which has its own control. Now this needs to be turned off because in user defined mode it is set as a note value on a MIDI keyboard. So if you're playing a virtual instrument, it will sound that note, and it's usually very high pitched, sort of in the 7th or 8th octave. So we just need to click each of these where there is a mouse cursor here, and then just go to null, and then again on here we'll go to null, and that's it. So that means that when we touch the fader now, we won't have any note sound. So I'll just press connect here, choose my Platform M Plus, connect to it, and then send the data. And there we go, the data's been sent. It's worth noting that if you close the iMap software now, you will lose any changes that you've made. The data will obviously still be in the Platform M Plus, but the layout will have completely changed again. So it's always worth just saving this. I'm gonna save this as instrument controller. And that means that I can reload this at any time if I want to tweak it or change any of the CC values, for instance. So now that we're all set up in the iMap software, we can go over to our DAW and start loading up an instrument to look at. So what I'm gonna open up here is Spitfire Audio's Lab Series. Now, the Lab Series is a bunch of really cool free to download instruments. So if you've never seen those before, I would really advise you check those out, and I'll leave a link in the description box below. So what I'm gonna do is just open it up here, and then under here, I'm gonna choose one of the things that I've already downloaded. Let's go for Tape Orchestra Strings Soltasto. Now, if I move these faders, now you can see that they are moving in the plugin. Let's just play a couple of chords and you can see how, or hear how this affects the sound. As I say, these CC commands that we're using here are quite universal. They'll work on a great deal of virtual instruments. So let's load up Studio Strings inside Logic here. And then I've got the dynamics via CC on here currently. And then let's just have a listen to this. Same thing again there. All right, how about a contact library? Contact from Native Instruments is obviously a very popular sampler. Let's just check out one of the libraries in Contact. So I've got an 8DO string library here as well. Let's just load this up. And there you go, it works exactly the same as the other instruments that I've shown you. Now, of course, a lot of other instruments come with other CC controls mapped to them. If you just check the MIDI mapping section of the manual or search online, you'll be able to find all of the controls and what they're mapped to in terms of the MIDI controls. And in that instance, for things like Spitfire, you'd be able to control the reverb or the attack and release of your instruments. And that means you could create some really interesting effects, as well as having a working expression and modulation controller. Now, thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please do make sure that you like it and subscribe to our channel so that you get to see all of our future content. Thanks very much, guys, and I'll see you again next time.